leider, maar nooit een leider, dat er ook in de kiezer. Oh, and you be confessing, there is a blessing when you walk.
Yeah.
number one would surely be me. I thought I would be what I wanted. But I can't even walk without you holding my hand. I thought I could do a lot of couldn't make it. Oh, alone. I thought of myself as a mighty big man, but I can't.
Praise God, praise God. I can't even walk without him holding my hand. Jesse Dixon, may his beautiful soul rest in peace. We give God the praise for tonight, for making it possible for us to gather together and to continue where we left off yesterday. I would like to give honor to all the elders in the church, give honor to all the pastors, give honor to all who are workers in the church, all the members of Fresh Anointing all over the United States and beyond. I realize there are members of this church who are outside New York City and even outside the United States who are faithfully tuning us in. Whenever we are on the air, we appreciate you very much, especially those of you from Africa. It takes a lot of money to do what we're doing, and I thank you that you deny yourself financially to join us. God bless you real good. I want to thank all who are all over the United States, who are not necessarily members of this church, but who are friends of this church, dedicated friends of this church, loving friends of this church, all across the United States. We appreciate you for joining us and for praying for us. I want to thank those in Guyana, especially, and in Jamaica, and in many of the Caribbean island countries that we have seen on the statistics May God bless you. Our next door neighbors, the good people in the great country of Canada, we are grateful that you choose to join us every time we are on the air. Traveling across the pond to the great, great, great United Kingdom and all other European countries, we appreciate you joining us also. May God make this a blessing to you every time you join. I want to say a big thank you to all of you for spreading the word about these prayers, especially those of you who listen to the podcast. Something happened on the podcast. Yesterday was the highest we've ever had since we started this last year. So many people were on the podcast yesterday. And I know it's because you are spreading the word. Please continue to do what you are doing. I think everybody ought to be part of these prayers. And I think you are a living testimony to how blessed you have been. Last night was very, very encouraging. And I believe God will do great things in our lives this month. Believe it or not, the testimonies are already coming through from last night. Right. Just last night, less than 24 hours. These testimonies are already coming through. We serve a God whose spirit is able to resurrect that which is dead. The unexpecteds are already happening, people. Graves are already being opened. What has been deemed as dead and buried already being resurrected. For that, we give God the praise. You know, someone testified this afternoon to how he suddenly, unexpectedly, just this afternoon, saw a huge deposit in his account. Lo and behold, it was from his tenant who had been owing rent for 2 years. And this person and his wife were not expecting this money at all. And they had resolved that, well, the courts will have to settle the issue. Well, remember we prayed last night that the Holy Spirit will go after that which is dead financially? Well, he did. Because suddenly, without any prior notice, after the prayer of last night, that which ought to be done was done. Well, we give God the praise for that testimony. The Spirit of the living God will go after all those that owe you money and all the monies that ought to come in for you and chase them down and cause them to release what is yours. Another testimony came in this afternoon. Here is from another person who wrote that his daughter had been helping her financially for over 3 years now. It's like clockwork. The money will come in. You know, after you've got something for 3 years, you assume it to keep on coming, right? No, suddenly, her daughter stopped sending the money for no reason. It's not because her daughter had any financial problem, all right? She's even got races upon races where she worked as a blessing for what she did for his mother. I mean, for her mother, rather. She stopped. And that was part of the prayer last night. The good thing is, as this lady said, I didn't fight my daughter. I didn't even ask her for the money because she was not under any obligation to send me the money. It was out of the goodness of her heart. But why she stopped, I didn't know. And I wasn't going to let that strain our relationship. But I know I could tell it to Jesus. So last night, when we were talking about raising the dead, well, all of a sudden, immediately after the prayer last night, this is what is amazing. Immediately after the prayer finished last night, she was shocked and surprised that her daughter sent her more than what she used to send before. Praise God. You know what? God will make them pay you what they owe you with interest. The dead can truly resurrect. And I really believe that more resurrections will be experienced in this, our month of resurrection. That's where I want your faith to be. That's why I said any prayer that you pray, you should tie it to a need in your life. Don't just pray general prayers, all right? Because some of the prayer points that I give are general prayers, but you can personalize them and make them applicable to whatever your need is. Let us pray. Papa, we thank you that you're a God who hears and answers prayers. These testimonies attest to the fact that when we call on you in faith, you come through for us. Thank you for this that we know, and many more that we don't know, and many, many more that are on the way. We pray that you will take all the glory and take all the praise and take all the honor and take all the dominion and take all the majesty, because you are worthy to be praised. We're here again, Lord. We are always in need. We pray that you will satisfy us today, even as we pray unto you. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen and amen. I promised you yesterday that today and tomorrow we will look at two different sayings of Jesus on the cross. We will examine one today, and the other one we will pray about tomorrow. Of course, I already told you what we are going to do tonight. I said we are going to take the number three saying on the cross. There were seven of them. The first one says, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. The second one says, today you will be with me in paradise. The third one says, woman, behold that your son, and son, behold your mother. Number four, my God, why hast thou forsaken me? Number five, I thirst. Number six, it is finished. Number seven, Father, into thy hands I commit my spirit. Now the third one, which is our focus for tonight, can be found in the book of John, chapter 19. Verses 26 and 27. Let me read it to you. When Jesus therefore saw his mother and the disciples standing by, whom he loved, he saith unto his mother, Woman, behold thy son. Then saith he to the disciple, Behold thy mother. And from that hour, that disciple took her unto his own home. Major lesson to learn here. And you know what it is? Jesus specializes in connecting people with people that will help them. Yes, sir. Jesus specializes in connecting people with people that will help them. It is true that the Bible says, My God shall supply all your needs according to his riches in Christ Jesus. But the question is how? 99.99% of the time, he uses people. You look into your life. Many of the good things that have happened in your life are as a result of God connecting you to the right people. Your life can become different with divine connection to help us. Your business can be transformed by connecting you to divine helpers. Look in your life, the house you bought. Look in your finances. Look in your education. Look in your ministry. More than likely, there was a divine connection that made all these things possible. Now, on Friday, the 24th of July last year, I checked it out. 24th of July, Friday of last year, we used this same passage of scripture to pray on this prayer line. If you've been with us for a while, you will remember that. July 24th, you can check the episode out. We used this scripture to pray. We are going to use this scripture again to pray tonight, but guess what? We are not even going to go the direction we went last year. No, 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 no. What I want to do tonight is focus on a different aspect and not repeat the same prayers that we prayed last year. Look at that verse again. Verse 26. When Jesus therefore saw his mother and the disciples standing by whom he loved, he saith unto his mother, Woman, behold thy son. Then saith he to the disciple, Behold thy mother. And from that hour, that disciple took her unto his own home. Do you see what I see in those verses? That's what I want to show you tonight. Because I never talked about this last year. When we looked at those verses and prayed on them, you will see another direction here tonight. Do you notice that Jesus was not asking John if he would take his mother? No, no, no. Jesus was not asking John if he could take his mother in. Jesus, hallelujah, was not pleading with John. Jesus, neither was he begging John. Do you know what Jesus did? He commanded John as if he was saying, John, that's your mother now. Take her home and be her helper. It was a commission that God gave him. It was a commandment that Jesus gave him. That is what I want us to pray about tonight. You're going to enjoy this, people. I just pray we'll have enough time to be able to cover all the prayer points that I have here. I have about 72 prayer points on that which we are going to pray about tonight. We are going to pray that those who are to help you will receive clear command from God to do so. That they cannot refuse. You see, if man commands them, they can refuse. We've all experienced that. You go to a big man, and the big man says, oh, you want something? And you say, yes. He calls a smaller man, and he hands you over to them. And that's where it finishes. That's where it ends. It never happens like that with God. Whoever God commands will carry out the commandment. When the command is from God, nobody can refuse it. That is what we want to focus on in our prayers tonight. Command my helpers. Command my helpers. Command my helpers. Like he commanded the ravens to feed Elijah. Command my helpers. Like he commanded the widow woman to feed Elijah. If you look at those scriptures in 1 Kings chapter 17, in verse number 4, it shall be that thou shalt drink of the brook. That's God speaking to Elijah. And then he said, I have commanded the ravens to feed thee there. I have commanded. Oh, even God can command birds to do his bidding on your behalf. And then when it got to verse 9, after the brook had dried up, the Bible says, God said to Elijah, Arise, get thee to Zarephath, which belongeth to Zidon, and dwell there. Behold, look at that word again. I have commanded a widow woman there to sustain thee. You see, it is one thing to have helpers around you. It is another thing for such helpers to be specifically commanded to help you. Without divine commandment, human connection is of little value. Shall I repeat that? Without divine commandment, human connection is of little or no value. That's why you have people that can help you get a job. That's why you have people that can help you get a position. And all they would do is they will say, yeah, I'll do it. I'll take care of it. But they will never do it because God has not got involved to command them directly and say, you go do it. And that's what we are going to believe God for tonight. You know why God is able to do that? The book of Proverbs says in chapter 21, verse 1, the king's heart is in the hand of the Lord. As the rivers of the water, of water, he turneth it whithersoever he will. I pray that God will turn the hearts of helpers towards you. He commanded light to be, and it was. He commanded the world to be, and it was. There are potential helpers all around you, but God has to nudge them to comply. Before we plead with God to command our helpers today, there's one more thing I want to say. Just as there are human helpers, there are also angelic helpers. They are unseen helpers, more powerful than human helpers. Do you know also that angels only help those that they are commanded to help? Yeah. An angel can sit around and do nothing if God does not give them the command. Okay, stand up, do this for him. Stand up, do that for him. The Bible says in Psalm 91, in verse number 10, there shall no evil befall thee, neither shall any plague come near thy dwelling. Now look at verse 11, for he shall give his angels charge over thee. Did you see that? He shall give his angels charge over thee to keep thee in all thy ways. In other words, he shall give them commandment. He shall give them authority. If he does not give them charge, they don't go charging. No, they stay put. But the moment he tells them, all right, rise up for Janet, rise up for John, they will rise up and do wonders on your behalf. If he doesn't say anything, they just sit down there. Why did James die? I often wonder in the book of the Acts of the Apostles. Why did James die and Peter lived? The reason is very simple. Because an angel was not commanded to go and help James. If an angel had been commanded to go and help James, James will not have died the way he died. But an angel was commanded to go and help Peter. And the angel rose up, moved in, and delivered Peter. Listen, folks. Where they are sent to, that's where they go. But in the case of Peter, though, I must say this to you. People prayed. Hence, helping angels were sent. But in the case of James, nobody prayed. Consequently, no angel was sent. Do you get my point? That's why we are going to pray tonight. Whether human helpers, whether angelic helpers, in response to your prayers, as God responded to the prayers of the church on behalf of Peter, God will rise up for you and respond and send angelic helpers your way and send human helpers your way. Let me stop right here and let us go on and pray tonight. I want you to say, Lord, I give you praise, I give you glory, I give you honor, I give you dominion, I give you majesty. I want you to thank God for bringing us together to this place of prayer tonight. I want you to thank God for bringing us together to this place of intercession tonight. I want you to say, Lord, I praise you. Lord, I worship you. Lord, I adore you. Lord, I honor you. Come on, open your mouth and talk to the Lord tonight and tell him how much you love him, how much you thank him, how much you bless him. Thank God for bringing us together, 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 together again tonight. Thank him again for allowing us to see the month of April. Hallelujah. Thank God that April 1st is here. We bless the name of the Lord for allowing us to see April. Thank him for this is our month of resurrection. I wanted to say, Lord, I thank you. We have declared that this month is the month of resurrection, and we are beginning to see resurrection testimonies around us. Father, we bless you. We worship you for the testimonies that came in today. We thank you for the testimonies that we don't even know about. We thank you for the testimonies that will come in all through this month. Every day for everyone on this prayer line shall be a day of testimony. Papa will bless you. Thank you, Lord God. Thank him that all things considered dead are coming alive this month in your life. All things that the doctors have said are dead, that the bankers have said are dead, that those who know have said are dead, as a result of your prayers, they will come alive tonight and every day this month, according to our prayers of this month. Thank him that as far as he is concerned, nothing is considered dead. In the name of Jesus, when you give it to him, the Spirit that raised up Jesus from the dead will raise up anything and everything that is dead around you. I wanted to thank him for the presence of the Holy Ghost that will make all these things possible for you, that will make all these things possible for me. Thank God for his wind. Thank God for his wind blowing evil out of our way and blowing good things into our lives. Say, Lord, I give you praise. I give you glory. I give you honor. I give you dominion. It's just that God doesn't sit and tell you, see what I blew away. See what I blew away. See what I blew away. Most of the things he blows away, we have no idea whatsoever. I just want you to thank him, even though you don't know what they are. That, Lord, I thank you for blowing evil away from us, oh God. I thank you for blowing good into our lives, oh God. Great and mighty God will bless you. Great and mighty God will glorify you. Great and mighty God will honor you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for your winds. Thank you, Lord, for your winds that are still blowing, blowing evil out of our way, blowing evil out of our lives, and blowing good things into our lives. We give you the praise, oh God. I want you to thank God for the third saying on the cross tonight. That's the crossroad where we are on this week. That is said to be a holy week. I want you to thank God for the third saying on the cross. Thank God that through suffering on the cross, he was still concerned about helping his mother. I want you to thank God for the mind of Christ, because the same thing he did for his mother, he will do for you. The same thing he did for his mother, he will do for me also. Thank God for his concern over your life. It's just the same. Hallelujah, Lord, I give you praise. Hallelujah, Lord, I give you glory. I give you honor. Thank God that his concern for you is just the same. Come on, people, let's thank God for his power to command tonight. Because that is where we are for the prayers of tonight. He is of all power to command. He is a commander in chief. Hallelujah. God is the commander in chief. He's able to command human beings because of you. He's able to command angelic beings because of you. In fact, he's able to command demonic beings because of you. And just command them to get out in the name of Jesus. Thank God for for his concern over you is ripe tonight for a miracle. It's your turn. I wanted to thank God for the commands he has issued on your behalf in the past. Many of you can testify that only God could have moved upon the heart of so and so. Only God could have moved for this to happen and for that to happen is because he issued a command on your behalf. I wanted to thank God for his power that has issued commands before on your behalf. Thank God for the commands that he will issue on your behalf tonight. I want you to just thank him in advance. We're here to receive a miracle, oh God. We thank you because of commands that you will issue to the kings in our lives, the commands that you will issue to the queens in our lives, the commands that you will issue to the powers that be in our lives that will favor us. Papa, we bless you, we worship you, we adore you in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. I want you to pray right now that nothing will make God, that nothing will make God. Come on, pray that prayer. Pray that nothing will make God to be reluctant about commanding helpers on your behalf. Say, oh Lord, please, Lord Jesus, let nothing make you reluctant to issue commandments on my behalf, oh God. All sins, all unbelief, let them not hinder me tonight. Papa, wash them away, command them to leave me alone. The temptations that have fallen into that break your heart, Papa, command it, issue command against it to leave me alone in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Papa, let every sin be forgiven. Let every iniquity be washed in the blood tonight. Let every unbelief be swallowed up by faith in God tonight. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, pray for grace tonight. Say, Lord, give me grace to be able to pray tonight. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Papa, I'm asking you for grace to be able to lead this prayer tonight, because without you, I cannot do anything. I cannot lead a prayer meeting for 5 minutes except for the grace of God. But if God gives the grace, we can be here for 5 hours and we are not tired. Papa, will just ask you for your help tonight. Come on, open your mouth and ask him for help. Say, Lord, help me to pray tonight. Say, Lord, come and help me to intercede tonight. Say, Lord, come and help me to call on you tonight. I pray that all distractions will be taken out of my way, oh God. I pray that all attractions from prayer will be taken out of my way, oh God. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. You know, I want us to pray about our prayer life as we begin again like we did yesterday. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I want you to pray tonight, pray tonight, pray tonight for grace, 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 grace. Grace to be able to pray tonight, the Lord will release it to you. Grace to be able to pray tonight, the Lord will release it upon you. In the name of Jesus, Papa, release grace to pray tonight upon me. Release power to pray tonight upon me. Release anointing to pray tonight upon me. Both the leader and those that pray the prayers, let grace be poured out upon us tonight in the name of Jesus. We want you to pray tonight. We want you to pray tonight. I want you to pray tonight. It was prayer. It was prayer, people. It was prayer that triggered God to command angels to release Peter. I want you to pray tonight that impossible situations in your life, difficult situations in your life will not be able to remove the interest of prayer from your life. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, I want you to pray that delays of answers to prayer will not hinder you from praying again, that the interest of prayer will not dry up in your heart, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, that you will not wait until something bad happens before you pray. These people waited till somebody died before they woke up to see the need to pray. I want you to pray tonight. tonight. When things are going well, Papa, make me a prayer warrior. When things are not going well, Papa, make me a prayer warrior. Papa, don't let me wait till things go bad before I start crying and before I start calling. When things are smooth, oh Lord, make me a woman of prayer. When things are not smooth, oh Lord, make me a man of prayer. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, I want you to pray that the spirit of prayer will possess you fully, will possess you forever. The spirit of prayer possess me tonight. Spirit of prayer possess me fully. Spirit of prayer possess me completely. Spirit of prayer possess me forever. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, I want you to pray tonight, pray tonight, pray tonight. I don't know. I'm just saying it. Maybe it was a lack of prayer. Probably it was a lack of prayer for James that led the angel not to be sent to him for his release. I want you to pray tonight that prayerlessness will die from your life from tonight. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, say, oh Lord my God, let prayerlessness die from my life from tonight. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, Papa, let prayerlessness die from my life from tonight, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. I want you to pray for mercy, pray for mercy, pray for mercy, pray for mercy. I want you to pray that the thing that makes you not to take problems seriously, that's what they did to James. So they did not take the problem serious, and it was too late. The poor man died just like that. I want you to pray for mercy, 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 in the name of Jesus, to be a woman of prayer, mercy, to be a man of prayer, that your prayerlessness will not end at this prayer meeting, that during the day you will pray, during the night you will pray, as you go to work you will pray, as you cook in the kitchen you will pray, as you mow your lawn you will be praying, as you do whatever you do in life you will be praying. I want you to pray for possession, 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 possession. Papa, possess me with the spirit of prayer. Papa, possess me with the power of prayer, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. I want you to pray tonight that everything you have lost as a result of prayerlessness, the mercy of God will give it to you. Every blessing that you have missed in the past because of your prayerlessness, everything that has died in your hand, died in your life because of prayerlessness, the mercy of God will bring them to life for you tonight, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Papa, have mercy on our prayer lives tonight. Papa, have mercy on our prayer lives tonight. Strengthen them, O God, with the cord of grace tonight. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. I want you to pray tonight, pray tonight, pray tonight, pray tonight. Let's go into our prayer tonight. We are going to ask the Lord to command things for us. You know why I said that? The Bible says we can command God to command for us. God himself said, concerning the works of my hand, command ye me. I want you to pray tonight. Say, Lord of mercy, have mercy on me. Oh, say, oh Lord, command men and angels to start ministering to my needs from today. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Say, oh Lord, my commander, command angels, command men to start ministering to my needs from tonight. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Say, oh Lord, you are the great commander tonight. Whatever you command always comes to pass. Papa, arise for me tonight. Papa, arise for me tonight. And command men and command angels to begin to arise and walk for me tonight. Connect me with men. Connect me with angels that are commanded by the God of heaven. Did you hear what I said, ladies and gentlemen? I said you should pray tonight that the Lord will command angels, the Lord will command men, the Lord will command people on your job, the Lord will command people in your family, the Lord will command the powers that be in your ministry to begin to walk on your behalf, in the name of Jesus. Say, oh Lord, command men, oh Lord, command angels to start ministering to my needs from tonight onwards, in the name of Jesus. You need to be specific now. Make mention those needs to God. Whatever the needs are, I want you to be specific and tell God, this is the need. Command angels to minister to this need. This is the need. Man can meet this need. Papa, minister to them, minister to them, minister to them. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Come on, open your mouth and tell the Lord tonight that the Lord will speak to angels. The Lord will give commission to angels. The Lord will commission men. The Lord will commission people, whether voluntarily or involuntarily, whether they are willing or they are unwilling. Once God speaks, who can say they are not going to be willing? I want you to pray tonight. Say, oh Lord, where I lack tonight, command providers to help me in the name of Jesus. Say, oh Lord, where I lack tonight, in the name of Jesus, I want you to command providers to help me, O God, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Where I lack tonight, in the name of Jesus, and the best of us have needs in our lives. The best of us have things that we lack. Say, my Father, my God, where I lack tonight, command providers to help me, O God, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I want you to pray tonight. There are people around you that can help you. There are people around you that can help you, but they have not received any commandment from God because you have not told God to command people to help you. I want you to pray that, oh Lord, all those that are just looking at, they are just looking at you. All those that are just looking at me, oh God. All those that are just looking at my children on their job. All those that are just looking at my husband on his job. At my wife on her job, and all they have to do is do something, say something. I want you to pray tonight, oh Lord, command them, all the onlookers, all those that are on the sideline that can help me, all those that are sitting on the sideline, they see my problem and I talk to them, and all they say is, I will be praying for you, when actually they don't need to pray, they just need to act and do something. They can solve the problem for me. I want you to pray, Lord God, command angelic human onlookers. Command angelic, command human, all onlookers, oh God, that are just looking at me. I want you to command them, oh Lord, to become helpers. I want you to command them to become helpers. I want you to tell the Lord to choose them, to select them. Whoever they are that God selects, he will be fine with you. Lord, just command them, command them, command them, command them. In the name of Jesus, my uncle commanded them, they did nothing. The senior man commanded them, they did nothing. The senior man connected them and connected them to me. Father, nothing that they have done. They said, I should bring application. Nothing came out of it. But if you will command them, oh, they will be running like crazy. Papa, arise tonight, arise tonight, arise tonight. Command, help us. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, help us that will take me to the next level. Did you hear what I said? They say the next level in front of you, you know. I want you to pray tonight, help us that will take me to the next level. Let them begin to respond to God's command in the name of Jesus. Help us, help us, help us. There are many of them all around the place. Help us that will take you to the next level. I want you to tell the Lord that they will begin to respond to the commands of God in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Papa, talk to them in the morning, talk to them in the afternoon. Papa, talk to them in the evening, talk to them all the time. Help us, help us, help us, help us. That will take me to my next level. Let them begin to respond to you, O God. Let them begin to respond to you, O God. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I want you to pray tonight, pray tonight, pray tonight. That unconcerned human beings, they will take up your case because God commands them. Say, O Lord, command them. Unconcerned, unconnected human beings. Let them take up my case immediately, oh God. I bet John never had any idea. John never had it in his mind when he was standing before the cross. But Jesus said, yes, I've selected you. I want you to pray tonight to all those that are just standing around. They have the capacity to do it. It doesn't even cross their mind. They have the ability to do it. It it just doesn't cross their mind. I want you to pray tonight. Pray tonight. They are all over our offices. They are all over our churches. They are all over our neighborhoods. They are all over our families. Unconcerned, unconnected human beings. And don't say, what concern me in that? I want you, Lord, to command them. Let it be their concern. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Papa, commandment, 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 commandment. Commander in chief. Papa, command them, command them, command them, command them. They are just standing around. They see me suffering. They are just standing around. They see me loafing around. But you can command them to get into action. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. I want you to pray tonight. Pray tonight that your helpers will suspend whatever they are doing. Ah, yes. Papa, command my helpers tonight to suspend whatever they are doing. Say, oh Lord, say, oh Lord, command them, command them, command my helpers to suspend what they are doing, to put aside whatever they are doing and start working for me, oh God. Are you praying where you are tonight? In the name of Jesus, please pray, please pray, please pray. That wherever your helpers are, the Lord will issue orders from his throne in the name of Jesus. All human thrones, did you hear what I said? All human thrones will receive a commandment from heavenly throne and they will start running for you in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Papa, issue commandments from your throne to the thrones of men, to the thrones of angels, and let them begin to move from me, O God. Let them begin to move for me, O God. Let them begin to walk for me, O God. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I want you to pray. I want you to pray. I want you to pray tonight. There are thrones around you that can elevate you. There are thrones around you that can help you. I want you to pray tonight that whatever those thrones are, wherever those thrones are, the Lord will command them in the name of Jesus. Wherever those kings and queens are, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, hey Lord, you will command them, issue orders, issue orders, issue orders. Papa, issue orders. Come on, pray, 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 pray. I like the way that brother is praying. I can see you nodding your head up and down. Papa, issue orders tonight from your throne in the name of Jesus to the throne room of human beings, from the throne of God to the throne of man. Set them in motion, set them in motion by your commandment to walk for me, O God. I've seen this before happening. I just don't have the time to tell you stories tonight. I want you to pray tonight, Lord God. Lord God, give me a testimony. Lord, give me a testimony. Lord, give me a testimony. Lord, give me a testimony. In the name of Jesus, order them from your throne. Order any human throne to begin to walk for me, to begin to favor me, to begin to be connected to me. Papa, connect me to thrones. Papa, connect me to thrones. Papa, connect me to powers and command them before I get there, oh God. In the name of Jesus, let them be looking for me everywhere. Papa, wherever the thrones are, where my helpers are, wherever the thrones are, where my helpers are, I pray that you will move on them, oh God, with your commandment. One word from you will make them come running. One word from you will make them come running. Papa, make them to run to my help. Make them to run to my aid by your commandment in the name of Jesus. I want you to pray tonight that wherever they are tonight, no matter where they are tonight, the Lord will command your helpers to connect with you in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Say, oh Lord, no matter where they are tonight, say, oh Lord, no matter where they are tonight, you will command my helpers to connect with me, O God, from the north, from the south, from the east, and from the west. You know, one young man told me, oh, he was just on YouTube, and a big man saw him on YouTube, and that's how he became helped by this big man. The big man said, I've never known you before, I've never seen you before, I just saw you on YouTube. He said, God, I believe God wants me to help you. I believe I have a command commandment from God to help you, and you will not believe it. The things that this man has done for this young boy, because somebody from heaven intervened. I want you to pray tonight. I want you to pray tonight where you don't think people will see you, where you don't think people will know you. The Lord will connect you with people by divine commandment. They will come from the north, from the south, from the east, from the west. They will come from the four corners of the world and connect with you supernaturally. Oh Lord, issue orders, issue orders, issue orders. No matter where they are, oh God, command my helpers to connect with me. Come on, pray tonight, pray tonight, pray tonight. I hope you are praying tonight. We all need help, oh, we all need help. Even me who is leading this prayer, I need help. No matter where they are tonight, oh God, no matter where they are tonight, oh God, command my helpers to connect with me and help me in the name of Jesus, from the north, from the south, from the east, from the west. Command powers in the name of Jesus. Hey, oh Lord, command powers that are blocking my helpers. Command them to disappear, to let me go. Powers that are hindering my helpers. Powers that are blocking my helpers. There are people that promise to help you, Jesus, and there are powers that talk them out of it. Say, oh Lord, issue a commandment from heaven, issue a decree from heaven. Powers that are blocking my helpers, make them to disappear in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, powers that are blocking my helpers, powers that are hindering my helpers, disappear, 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 in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, can I ask you to pray tonight that help us that will bring seasons of lack into seasons of plenty. The Lord will command them for you in the name of Jesus. The Lord will command your helpers and connect them to you. Help us that will bring seasons of lack into seasons of plenty. Oh Lord, command them, command them, command them, command them, command them. I want you to pray especially. Help us that have hardened themselves. You know, there are people that can just do it, but they harden themselves. I want you to pray tonight that potential helpers who have hardened their heart towards me, Papa, command them to receive a change of heart in the name of Jesus. Are you praying where you are tonight? There are people who can easily give you promotion. There are people who can easily transfer you to where you want. Just a stroke of the pen and it's done. Just a signature and it's done. But they harden themselves against you. I want you to pray tonight that those that have hardened themselves to you and who are in the power to help you, oh Lord, will command them tonight in the name of Jesus. Command them in their sleep that they will wake up the second day of April 2020 and they will come up with favor. They will come up with connection and the hardness of their heart will disappear in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, I want you to pray tonight that warrior angels, say, oh Lord, command warrior angels to get involved in all of my battles in the name of Jesus. Say, oh Lord, command warrior angels for me, oh God. Let them get involved in all my battles, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Lord, command them, command them, command them. Can I ask you to pray that the Lord will connect warrior angels to you? The Lord will command warrior angels to you, powerful angels to you. Lord, connect them to me, connect them to me tonight. Many of you are fighting battles. Many of us, don't let say many of you, many of us are fighting battles that only God can win for us. I'm talking about battles that you pray, 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 fast, 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 night vigil, night vigil, night vigil, from one revival to another, and nothing happens, from one prayer line to another, and nothing happens. You need to be connected with warrior angels. Say, oh, Holy Ghost, Papa, connect me with warrior angels tonight. Papa, connect me, warrior angels, tonight, and let them get involved in my battles, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I want you to pray tonight, warrior angels, mighty angels, seraphims and cherubims. Oh Lord, let them get involved in my battles tonight. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. I want you to pray tonight, pray tonight, pray tonight. When they sent a warrior angel to help Daniel, he couldn't do it. He didn't have the power to do it. So they sent another angel that was higher in grade, that was higher in power. Can I ask you to plead with God tonight? Say, oh Lord, my God, command angels that are higher in grade, command angels that are higher in power to get involved in my battles, to get involved in my case. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, angels that are greater in power, angels that are greater in strength, angels that are greater in ability, Papa, release them for me tonight. Papa, send them for my worry, for my wars tonight. Let them war for me. Let them fight for me. Let them do great and mighty exploits for me. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. I want you to open your mouth wide and tell the Lord, warrior angels, mighty warrior angels, angels of higher grade, angels of higher grade, let them be commanded, oh God, to get involved in this, my battle, oh God, with Satan. In this, my battle, oh Lord, with my siblings. In this, my battle, oh Lord, with the witches and wizards in my family. In the name of Jesus, in my husband's family. Papa, I need, oh God, angels commanded on my behalf. When the church prayed, you sent out an angel. The church is praying tonight, oh God, send out an angel for my children. Send out a warrior angel for my husband. Send out a warrior angel for my wife. Send out a warrior angel because of my dreams. Let them stand by me every night I sleep. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. I want you to pray the Lord will connect you tonight. The Lord will connect you with stronger angels that have been working for you in the name of Jesus. The Lord will connect you with higher powers, powers of higher grade, angels of higher grade, human beings of higher grade, oh Jesus. I want you to pray tonight, God will send you to people of higher grade. He will connect you with people of higher grade in the name of Jesus. You know it in the world. When you are connected with people that are high up there, everything becomes easy. But it takes God to command them. Say, Papa, command those that are high ups to rise up and help me, oh God. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, help us of higher caliber, help us of higher grade, connect, command them, oh God. Maybe you have something that needs to be signed, and 2 months, 3 months, 5 months, 1 year, they just put in there, they don't sign it. Say, oh Lord, command them to sign it, command them to approve it, command them to give me, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, Papa, powers that can just their signature and the money rolls in, just their signature and the promotion rolls in, just their signature and the elevation comes in. Papa, command them tonight. Papa, command them tonight. You know what your situation is. There is a judge sitting on your case. Just his words, and the case is closed. I want you to pray tonight, Lord, we command those that are in power. The Lord will command and command them and command them and command them in the name of Jesus to favor you in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Can we pray some prayers about Mary tonight? Say, oh Lord, my God, like Mary, like Mary, like Mary, like Mary, like Mary, like Mary, when I don't even know I need connection. Say, Papa, issue connections, issue commandments for me, oh God. Mary did not, this Jesus. Mary did not know she needed connection. Oh, he was just sitting there. She was just standing there in front of the cross. Her mind was not on connection. Her mind was on her son that was being killed, that was being bastardized. That was where her mind was. But the mind of God was in another place. place. I want you to pray tonight, what I don't know I need. Lord, issue command for connection for me, O God. Mary was standing there. Her mind was not on John. Mary was standing there. All she wanted to do was go back home. But God had another thing in mind. I want you to pray tonight. Say, O Lord, concerning everything you have in mind concerning me, issue commands tonight. Issue commands tonight. Things that I don't know by myself. Things that are good for me that I don't even think of. Things that are good for me that is not even in my mind. Papa, issue commands tonight. Like you did, O God, on that fateful day as you were hanging on the cross. Papa, let me see your favor. Papa, let me see your mercy. Papa, let me see your kindness. There are things you need, my friends. There are things that are necessary in your life that you are not even aware of. I want you to tell the Lord, Papa, you have the right. Papa, you have the freedom. Begin to issue commandments, O God, about things I need that I don't know I need them. About things I should have that I don't know I should have them. Papa, issue the command this month of April, even beginning this second day of April. And for some of you, it is the third day of April. Papa, begin to speak. Papa, begin to issue command to the Johns in my life. In the name of Jesus, when I don't even know. When I don't even know that I need connection, Papa, issue the command. Give me a surprising command. You can imagine how surprised Mary must have been that, I was not thinking of this. Oh, I want you to pray tonight. Say, oh Lord, good things that I'm not thinking of. Issue commands concerning them. Good places that I'm not thinking of. Issue command concerning them. Good people that I'm not thinking of. Issue commands and connect me to them. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. I hope you are praying where you are tonight. I hope you are calling on God where you are tonight. The people that you don't even think of, places you don't even think of, blessings you don't even think of, needs that don't even bother you, the Lord will begin to issue commands concerning them, the right place, oh God. You know what happened to Mary? Suppose Mary was not there. Suppose Mary was not there. Suppose John was not there. I want you to pray tonight. Say, oh Lord, like Mary, let me be at the right place at the right time that you have said to issue commands of helpers. Papa, let me be there, oh God, when you are ready to issue commands of helpers. Mary heard it with her own ears. It's not that Jesus Christ said, okay, when you get home, help me tell Mary that she will now be living with John. No, she was there in the name of Jesus. I want you to pray tonight. She was not even expecting that to happen that day. I want you to pray tonight. Say, oh Lord, like Mary, like you did for Mary, on a day that I don't expect, connect me with helpers by command. On a day that I don't expect, at an hour that I don't expect, at a place that I don't expect. Oh Lord, issue command. Papa, issue command. Come on, pray tonight. Like you did for David, like you did for Mary. Maybe at the right place at the right time where you are issuing commands of helpers. Papa, let me not be absent. Papa, let me not be absent. Manipulation to be absent from where God is issuing blessings, where God is issuing commandments of connection of helpers. Papa, let me not miss it, oh God, like you did for Mary, oh God, on a day that I don't expect. Connect me with helpers in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, at a time that I least expect. Oh Lord, connect me with the right people. Come on, pray tonight on a day that you don't expect. You know, you can wake up on a day and your day can just change completely. Yes, you can just wake up on a day and God's commandment will just change your day forever, for good. May that day come to you this month of April, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Papa, like Mary, oh God, come on, open your mouth, say, oh Lord, say like Mary, oh God, let my tomorrow help us be selected for me today. Did you hear what I said? Like Mary, oh God, my tomorrow help us, let them be selected for me today, oh God, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. It's a simple command. Baba, anything and everything is so easy with you. You just say it just like that, and it's done, and a life is changed. Can I ask you something? Will you pray it? Say, Lord, let a simple command from you change my destiny. Oh my, oh yeah, mama. Pray that a simple command from God will change your destiny forever tonight. A simple commandment from God will connect you to your destiny and change it forever. Say, oh Lord, say, look into my future needs, because that was exactly what God did on that day. That was exactly what Jesus did on that day. He looked into the future needs of Mary and sent her ready-made help. Did you hear what I said? He sent her ready-made helper. He sent her ready-made helper by command. I say, oh Lord, issue command tonight about my future needs, oh Lord. Some of you are becoming senior citizens. You don't know what senior citizenship. You don't know what is going to bring for you. Say, oh Lord, issue command now. Before I become a senior citizen, that will make my old age to be beautiful. In the name of Jesus, somebody told me today, he said, do you know so-and-so is becoming senile. He is becoming talking gibberish and talking nonsense. I want you to pray tonight that your old age, the Lord will connect you with good health. The Lord will connect you with good health. If you are taking any medication right now that will trouble you when you become 70, that will trouble you when you become 80, I want you to pray that the Lord will disconnect you from that medication. The Lord will connect you with better medication that will not mess up your brain when you get to be 80 years old. Papa, my future is in your hand. Open your mouth and pray tonight. Say, Papa, my future is in your hand. Think about my future today, oh God. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. I've seen old people that you say, why don't this person just die? Why don't this person just die and not be suffering like this? They are virtually in every family. Oh, I want you to pray. Papa, command peace for my future. Papa, command peace connection. Whatever will bring me peace in my future, connect it to me in my today, oh God. Whatever will bring me peace for my tomorrow, command it into my life in my today. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. You know one thing? Mary never suffered in life. Mary never suffered in life because she was connected with compassionate helper. I want you to pray tonight. The commandment from heaven to help us, that will help you never to suffer. The Lord will issue it on this day. The helpers may not come until 10 years old. The helpers may not come until 5 years old. But come, they will come. If it is God that issues the commandment, I want you to pray tonight that I will not grow up suffering, because God will issue a commandment to compassionate help us, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Some people find help us when it is too late. Say, oh Lord, issue my commandment for help us before it is too late for me, oh God, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Who will go to John and say, John, stop helping Mary? Nobody dare do that. And if they do it, John is not going to listen, because the Ancient of Days is the one that gave him the commandment. I want you to pray tonight. Pray tonight. Say, my help us. Say, my help us. My help us. Let them be those that cannot be talked out of helping me. Let them not be those that can be biased out of helping me. Father, command them to stay faithful. Command them to stay faithful. Command them to stay consistent. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. I want you to pray for yourself tonight. I have to put this prayer in for you people. I have to put this prayer in for myself. You know what the prayer is? Say pride. Say pride. Say pride of self-sufficiency that makes people feel they need no helper. Say, oh Lord, disconnect me from such pride in the name of Jesus. Pride of self-sufficiency, pride of arrogance. Arrogance is pride. So pride of self-sufficiency that makes people feel that they need no helper. Papa, remove it from my life. Remove it far from me. Let it not be my portion, oh Lord. Let it not be my portion, oh Lord. Pride of self-sufficiency. I don't need anybody and you are still suffering. I don't need anybody and you are still crying. I don't need anybody and you have no money. I want you to, and God wants to connect you with a millionaire, with a multi-millionaire. I want you to pray tonight. Have you ever seen people who are hungry? And they give them for a say, no. I'm okay. They are not okay. Oh, arrogant, hungry man. I want you to pray tonight. Pride of self-sufficiency. Pride that doesn't want to seek help. There are some people that don't like to seek for help. They would rather help people than have people help them. I want you to pray that the Lord will break you and melt you. The Lord will change you and transform you in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Anything and everything about you that keeps you from wanting to get help, that keeps you from wanting to receive help, the Lord will take it away from you in the name of Jesus. The Lord will just humble you. Whichever helper you need, you will be willing and you will be ready. You will be able to say, I'm ready. Come on. I want you to pray tonight that as the Lord gave John, God did not give John a choice. So, did you notice that God did not give John a choice? No. I want you to pray tonight. Say, oh Lord, my God, as you did not give John a choice, as you did not give the ravens a choice, as you did not give the widow woman a choice. I want you to pray tonight. Say what I said again. Say, oh Lord, as you did not give John a choice, as you did not give the ravens a choice, as you did not give the widow woman a choice, let your command to my helpers give them no choice but to help. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Papa, give them no choice. Give them no choice. Give them no choice. Give them no choice. You remember the widow woman, even after she was commanded, she wanted to cop out. She wanted to run away. She wanted to avoid helping Elijah, but she could not. God has spoken. I want you to pray tonight. Pray tonight. Let them have no choice. Like the ravens had no choice. Let them have no choice. Like the widow woman had no choice. Let them have no choice. Like John had no choice. They will obey your command. They will do what you tell them to do for me tonight, and those that have forgotten, they will remember tonight, and they will start running, and they will start moving, and they will start helping in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, it was a command. Oh, Papa, command them, command them, command them. Let them have no choice as you command them. Command them, command them, command them. Let them have no choice as you commanded, as you command them. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Everybody say divine mandate. You know how you say you are mandated. You are mandated to do this. I have been mandated to do this. I want you to pray tonight that mandates will be written in heaven in the mighty name of Jesus. Divine mandates will begin to move helpers into your life. Divine mandates will begin to mandate helpers into your life from the north, from the south, from the east and from the west, and they will help your elevation in life in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, Papa, sign my order of helpers. Sign my order to help us tonight. Papa, I cannot help myself. Oh, sign my order of helpers on my job, in my ministry, in my marriage. bridge. Everywhere I need help, Papa, sign the order, send out the order, sign the mandate, send out the mandate to the north, to the south, to the east, and to the west, to people that can help me, to elevate me, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Can I pray for you professionals that are on this prayer line? I want you to pray tonight that the Lord will bring into your life. No, the Lord will command into your life experts in the field where you need help. Did you hear what I said? The Lord will command into your life experts in the field where you need help. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, the Lord will command experts in the field where you need help. In the name of Jesus, and connect you to them. Experts in the field where you need help. Experts in the need where your children need help. Can we pray for our children tonight that they will not go around in life looking for helpers. In the name of Jesus, let it be on record in heaven in your prayers tonight that your children will never lack a helper. In the name of Jesus, Papa, don't allow my children to lack helpers. Many of them are scattered all over the world. Many of them are scattered to different schools in the city, and they need helpers in the school. They need helpers on the job. I want you to pray, help us, help us, help us. Papa, command the helpers of my children where I am not there, O God, to help them. Let helpers be there to help them, O God, in the corporate world. Send them helpers in the corporate world. Command me, help us in the name of Jesus. In the business world, command helpers to come and help me. You know your business, so this is your business. It can really boom if you have the right people on it. I want you to pray for God to send you helpers, the right helpers that will help you with your business. In corporate world, help us. In business world, help us. In academic world, help us. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. In my academics, O Lord, command helpers to come and help me. In my business, O God, command helpers to come and help me. In my corporate world, command helpers to come and help me. Can I ask you to pray that in all your undertakings in life, the Lord will command helpers in all life's undertakings. In the name of Jesus, in all life undertakings. Look at the time. Time is gone. My Lord, we got just 2 more minutes. I want you to pray that in all that you have to do in life, there will be helpers that God has commanded. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Can I ask you to pray a prayer like this? That all that are in your life by mistake, all helpers that are hurters, you know what I mean? They hurt you rather than help you. I want you to pray, the Lord will transfer them out of your life in the name of Jesus. All that are there to hurt you and not help you, Papa, transfer them out of my life. Move them out of my life. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, send them where they will be able to help people. In the name of Jesus, command them, command them, command them, command them out of my life. In the name of Jesus, those who are there to hurt me rather than help me, Papa, move them out, move them out, move them out, move them out, move them out. In the name of Jesus, can I ask you, the Lord, to break the cord, break the cord of wrong connection in your life. Say, oh Lord, break them, break them, break them, break them, break them. All the cords of wrong connection in my life. In the name of Jesus, break them tonight. In the name of Jesus, break them tonight. Papa, Papa, Papa is the right helper I want. Like the Samaritan that was connected to the man that was injured between Jerusalem and Jericho. The Lord will command helpers to come. We are helpers, people who could have helped. The Levite could have helped. The priest could have helped. But they did not help. I want you to pray. Say, oh Lord, we are people that should have helped, have not helped me. Papa, send them, send the right helper to me, oh God. Command the right helper to come to me, oh God. Command the right helper to come to me, oh God. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. I want you to pray tonight. The widow I told you, oh, the widow was first reluctant. I want you to pray tonight. Every reluctant helper that you have told to help me, but they are reluctant. Say, Papa, prevail upon them. Prevail upon my reluctant helpers to begin to do your will right now for my life. All reluctant helpers, let them begin to do your will for my life, oh God. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, let them begin to do your will for my life, oh God. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Lord, I want lasting help, lasting help, lasting help. Command lasting help. In the name of Jesus, command lasting help. In the name of Jesus, command lasting help into my life, oh God. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. I want you to pray prayer also. I want you to pray prayer also. John lived the longest of all the apostles. I want you to pray tonight. My divinely commanded helpers. My divinely commanded help. We're about to close. My divinely commanded helpers. They will not die while I need them. In the name of Jesus. He never died while Mary needed him. I want you to pray tonight. Pray tonight. Pray tonight. Pray tonight. My divine helpers. They will not die while I need them. In the name of Jesus. Pray, 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 pray. Hey, those of you who have little children, 5-year-old, 10-year-old, 13-year-old, 18-year-old, I have a prayer point for you in a minute, but I want you to pray for yourself first of all, that those that are commanded to help you, Lord, don't let them die while I need them, oh God. Don't let them be transferred while I need them, oh God. Don't let them be terminated while I need them, oh God. Is there anybody helping you now? Is there anybody helping you now? And people see that they are helping you and they want to push them out. Oh Lord God, make them immovable, oh God, while I still need their help. Make them untouchable, oh God, while I still need their help. John never died. He died old and he took care of Mary. I don't know who died before the two of them. I don't know who died first among the two of them, but he died an old age. I want you to pray for long life for those who are helping you right now. They will not die young. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Now, those of you that have children, 5-year-old, 6-year-old, 2-month-old, 1-day-old, I want you to pray tonight. You have been commanded to take care of those children. I want you to pray tonight. You will not die while those children need you. You will not die while those children need you. Who will they call? Who will they call? It's you they will call. I even know of married children who will still call their parents for counsel. I want you to pray tonight, pray tonight, pray tonight, pray tonight. Say, my children, oh God, that you have commanded me to take care of. My children, oh God, that you have commanded me to watch over, that you have connected to me to help. Papa, don't let me die while they need me, oh God. Don't let me die while they need me, oh God. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, compensate me with long life. In the name of Jesus, so I can be able to help them, so I can be able to be around them. Command long life for me, oh God. Come on, open your mouth and pray good prayer for yourself, that the Lord will command long life for you, so you'll be able to help these children. If you die now, who will send them to school? If you die now, who will clothe them? If you die now, who will feed them? I pray for you tonight. May you live long. Oh Lord, command long life for me, oh God, because of my children. In the name of Jesus, Father, don't let me abandon these children while they still need me, while they will cry and cry and cry and say, who will take care of us now? Papa, let it not be my portion in my family. In the name of Jesus, pray for your children that have children, that the Lord will spare their lives also for their children. In the name of Jesus, they don't need you anymore, but their children need them. Papa, oh God, spare our lives to live long. Command long life for us, so we can be able to take care of those that need, that depend on us. In the name of Jesus, give us good health. Compensate us with good health. Compensate us with long life, that we'll be able to help the children women under us, the people under us, in the name of Jesus, that depend upon us. Papa, do it, 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 in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. I want you to begin to thank God. I want you to begin to praise God tonight. I want you to begin to say, Lord, I bless you for the Hey, a lot of commandments have been issued tonight. A lot of commands have been issued tonight. Say, Lord, I bless you for the commands that you have issued tonight. I bless you because of the things that you have spoken on my behalf tonight. In the mighty name of Jesus, they are established and they will be forever established. In the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, Lord, my helpers are now being served notices. Angels are traveling the four corners of the world and they are serving them notices. I want you to bless the name of the Lord. Say, Lord, I thank you for the notices that you are serving right now to people that need to be served so they can do their own duty in fulfilling my destiny in life. Father, I bless you for the answer. I worship you. I adore you. I honor you. I glorify you for answering my prayers tonight. Come on, thank him. Come on, praise him. Come on, glorify him. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen and amen and amen. Heavenly Father, we thank you for tonight. We thank you because you are the commander in chief. All power belongs to you. All authority belongs to you. You are the one that says it and it's done. You are the one that commands it and it is obeyed. Father, I praise your name for that. I thank you because of all the things we have committed into your commanding power. Father, command them accordingly, O God. And let us see the fruit of the prayers for tonight. Whether they are angelic beings or they are human beings, Papa, they are all at your command. They are all ministering spirits. I pray that you begin to command them to minister to us, whether it is in warfare, whether it is in workfare, whether it is in family fare, whatever it is, whether it is an educational fare, whatever it is that is confronting us, I pray that you will raise up helpers that will make us more than conquerors. We thank you. We bless you for the Joshuas that helped the Moses. We thank you for the Jonathans that helped the Davids. It's our own time where we need helpers. Send them in abundance by divine commandment, and we receive them by faith tonight. In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Spirit, in Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. And amen. And amen. And amen. And amen. And amen. I just felt we needed to pray this prayer from another angle of commandment. That's something we never touched on when we prayed last July. And I just pray that you will remember that at the back of your mind. They can be around you. If they are not commanded, they are not going to move. So you need to pray about that all the time. And I pray that all the people that you have told God to walk on, all the areas that you have told God to walk on, God is at work and you shall testify in the name of Jesus. We'll be back tomorrow night. God giving us the grace and God giving us the help. We'll be back tomorrow night at 7 o'clock New York time. And we are going to take another biggie, a big one, inside the seven sayings on the cross. That one is reserved for Friday. You don't want to miss it. Please help me tell a friend, tell a neighbor, tell somebody and invite them to the prayer line tomorrow. They can go and call in with their phone or they can log in through the podcast. And they will be blessed either way. Please also don't forget that this week will be our last week of praying on Wednesdays. We have suspended Bible study for over a year now. And that's not good for a church. We will just become illiterates that don't know the word of God. And you cannot pray correctly too if you don't know the word of God. So we feel that we need to go back to Bible study on Wednesdays and still continue with the prayers on Thursdays and on Fridays. So next Wednesday, help us spread the word. There will be no prayer line. The podcast will be silent next week on Wednesday alone. because we are going to be on Zoom for the Bible study. Already now, we have sent out all the information about the Zoom, the numbers and the passwords. If you have not got yours, please make sure you get them so you can join us at exactly 7 o'clock on next Wednesday. And then on Thursday and on Friday, we'll be back on the prayer line. Shall we share the grace as we go and rest for tonight? May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen and amen. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen and amen. And amen. Thank you so much for coming tonight. Go and rest and reap the fruit of your labor for tonight. Good night.